Hi friends, welcome to my channel Jassi Reviews. If you like my videos, don't forget to subscribe the channel so that you receive my latest videos. Friends, today we are going to talk about Mahindra Marazzo. The face sports Mahindra signature toothy grill. The headlamps appear a bit timid, and the LED DRLs would have been more impactful and attractive attached to the headlamps than the fog lamps, which is where they are currently located. 17-inch wheels, a rising waistline, and a rather tasteful use of chrome highlights, you could even call it sophisticated. That said, the upward sloping window line and the oversized tail lamps make the rear end seem bulky and the rear wheels a bit small. The Marazzo's footprint is larger than any other Mahindra passenger vehicle on sale at 4585 mm in length, 1866 mm in width, and 1774 mm in height. This makes it shorter and lower than Innova Crista, but it wider and has a longer wheelbase too. It sits on a ladder frame with a transverse engine powering the front wheels. However, though several components under the hood are made of plastic, the Marazzo still tips the scales at a hefty 1650 kg, lighter than the 1855 kg Innova, but 400 kg heavier than Artica. As far as engine or performance is concerned, the all-new 1497cc 4-cylinder diesel engine belongs to the McFalcon engine family. What noticeable right from startup is just how refined the engine is. There are not any vibrations to speak of, neither through the pedals nor the steering wheels. Nor does the gear lever dance about like the one in the Innova. The engine uses a plastic cam cover, the aluminium oil sump, low friction pistons, and an offset crankshaft, all to keep weight and vibrations low. And all this seems to have paid off. The weight performs at city speed. Also commendable. It pulls cleanly off the mark, but doing so calls for careful modulation of the clutch and the throttle. We did stall it a couple of times. There is a bit of turbo lag, but it quickly overcome as the engine picks up revs. The short gearing helps responsiveness, and the big Marazzo pulls well from as low as 1000 rpm. There's an eco mode on offer for those who looking to maximize efficiency. Driving the Marazzo can best be described as light as easy. The steering is light and so is the clutch, although the travel is long. The gear lever is a bit too tall and the throws are on the longer side, but here too effort is minimal. As far as ride and handling is concerned, the Marazzo gets a double wishbone front suspension with a stabilizer bar and a twist beam setup at the rear. That coupled with a 240 mm of suspension travel has done wonders for the way it tackles the rough. However, true to Mahindra ladder frame DNA, the Marazzo feels indestructible over bad and broken roads. Road shocks rarely filter through and lateral rocking movements are very well controlled. Now about the interior. Like the exterior, the Marazzo interiors too portray a sense of maturity. The clean and clutter-free dash looks great, while the beige and black color theme and a mix of materials complement the aesthetics well. The gloss back fascia finish adds some appeal to the cabin, but on a sunny afternoon, this surface becomes very reflective. Also, the white ceramic-like highlights on the dashboard and the purple instrument cluster might seem a bit quirky to some. As for quality, the feel of textured plastics and fit and finish in certain areas is surprisingly good. The driver's seat offers a commanding panoramic view thanks to the expansive glass area, and reversing this long MPV is quite easy with its large rear windscreen and easy to judge edges. The 7-inch touchscreen infotainment system is easy to use with a good touch sensitivity and an interface that quick to respond. What nice is that it gets Android Auto, but Apple CarPlay is not available for now. The user interface too is fairly easy to work with, but it could still do with a bit more spit and polish. The seats themselves are large, very supportive and upholstered in leather. The front ones even get lumbar support adjustments and individual armrest, adding to the overall comfort. In the 7-seat configuration, the middle row gets captain seats while the 8-seater gets a bench that slides and reclines in a 40-60 split. Unique to the Marazzo is the rear air conditioner, which has a blower unit running the length of the car with side firing vents. Once seated in the third row, headroom is not much of concern and space is not too bad. Sure, the seat is a bit low, so one sits in the knees up position. And because of the middle seat rails, you need to wiggle your feet to find room. But compared to some of its rivals, this row can accommodate adults quite comparably for a considerable amount of time. Cabin ergonomics is one area where Mahindra should have put in some more effort. Storage areas are plenty throughout the cabin. There are large open cavity on the top of the dashboard. The large door bins can easily hold 1-liter bottles, and there are cup holders in every row. As far as fuel efficiency is concerned, in eco mode, the Marazzo returned some respectable efficiency figures. Like in city, it achieved 12.5 km per liter, slightly better than the lighter 10 HP Renault Logi, 12.3 km per liter, and the much better than the Innova 2.4 MT, which offers 10.6 km per liter. Out on the highway, the Marazzo returned 15.5 km per liter, also better than Toyota 14.3 km per liter, but not quite as good as the Logi, which provides 17.5 km per liter. Now, as far as features are concerned, there is only one engine and transmission options currently available across the Marazzo 4 variants, M2, M4, M6 and M8. Safety kit like ABS, EBD, dual airbags, all-wheel disc brakes and ISOFIX child field mounts are standard on all. The bottom three variants get both 8 and 7-seater options, whereas the top trim is only available in the 7-seat configuration. Now, as far as the verdict, Mahindra has outdone itself with the Marazzo in terms of design and quality. As a people mover, it is spacious, comfortable and well equipped. The engine refinement and effortlessness in the city are highlights, and the car light controls. High seating and excellent visibility make it nice and easy to drive. The body on-frame construction gives it a sense of indestructibility over bad roads, and this 1.5 liter diesel engine could have done with stronger performance, particularly with a full load of passengers, and sub cabin ergonomic quick should have been sorted out. Hi friends, welcome to my